Guys, it's your girl coming to you today. I do not own any rights to this music, but what I'm listening to right now is Memories featuring John Legend. I can't say the artist's name, but anyway, lighting some sage. Let's set the mood here. Clear the energy. Clear my energy. Clear your energy. Look at the sun shining on me as I clear my energy. Hey, thank you. Yeah. All right, let me sit this down, y'all. Okay. So, we're gonna first start off with the numerical. Neurology, I don't know why I always say numerical. Guidance cards here. Okay. Alright. I'm sipping on a little wine, y'all. So, excuse me. Let's get into this read. Y'all, I burned myself with some wax trying to save money. Because my family grows hair on their, the women grow hair on their chin, and sometimes it be a little too defined for me. So therefore, I have to go ahead and wax it off. Y'all, I burn myself. But anyway. Alright, so somebody could possibly be into a spiritual career. Nature is definitely taking, you may need to get out of nature in order to get more messages that you need from God, or more messages that you need from higher power to help you manifest this spiritual career. Maybe you want to be, like I said, a pastor beforehand, a spiritual teacher, anything of that nature. Yeah, but you're going to have to learn how to be financially disciplined when you do this. You're going to have to learn how to be financially disciplined, because it's going to play a major part in your spirituality and your career, basically. Yes, because as you're coming upon a 10 as a completion, you have completed a karmic cycle. So therefore, finances may be a problem. And you're seeking spiritual help so that you can at least maintain what you have. You know, it may be a, because this karma completion is a 10, you may be coming into some money situations or that nature. Okay, let's see. Yeah, because you need more physical activity. You need the nature. You need nature, more physical activity. You need things that are going to physically stimulate you, so therefore you can think clearly, and you must have patience as well. You're going to have to exercise patience, because at this point I know patience, when you want something, patience is really, 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 really thin, but you have to believe and make sure that you are taking care of yourself physically and emotionally and finances as well, okay? Yeah, you got to have, here's self-discipline now. You have financial discipline and self-discipline, so you may have to be take control of your finances and yourself and make sure that you don't overspend, or you may have to, become into your own. This is 11. Which is like a new beginning. So coming into your own, you may want to come into your own and start being more disciplined about the things that you're doing in life. You may want to be more disciplined about the things that you're doing in life, because you realize you have a connection with God in so many ways, and it's very, 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 very thick. It's a thick partnership, because I'm telling you, I see a spiritual partnership right here and teaching and learning. So you may be teaching and learning yourself about your spirituality all over again. Excuse me, y'all.
take a drink, man.
And it may be something hard for you to understand. Ooh, see, there it is. It's hard for you to do because you have a pride situation. That's probably why my throat closed up, because all of a sudden my throat closed up and I had to cough. So pride may be getting an issue, may be beginning to be an issue in this situation. You have to sometimes always learn to be teachable, okay? 9 + 1 = 10, another completion, okay? So you need to complete this ego and this pride attitude. You have to drop down to your knees and get spiritual to get what you need out of life. Somebody needs prayer and meditation. And we all need prayer and meditation every day. We need to focus on it. Somebody needs to focus on it. Okay? Because their environment around them may be telling them or maybe hindering them to have the peace and serenity that they need in order to, yes, Lord, yes, perseverance. So it's hindering them. Their environment is hindering hindering them from persevering into the type of situation or the type to be the person that you want to be or to live the life that you want to live. This your environment may be hindering you. Okay. Yes, and you need to learn how to forgive yourself and forgive others. I always say it all the time. If you don't forgive other people, how do you expect God to forgive you? So we all have done things that are not of us. However, how do we expect God to forgive us for everything and not judge us and still open up those gates for us if we can't start forgiving each other and ourselves, okay? All right. Yes, because I'm going to say two things. You have to always lead with love, okay? Always lead with love with anything that you start off doing, because when you lead with love, nothing but love is going to transform through it, and it's going to transpire through it, and it's going to make sure, and when you lead with love, let me tell you, when you lead with love, I guarantee you things work out. 7-Eleven as I'm on the clock right now looking at it. But when you lead with love, nothing but love can come from it, okay? And you also may be having love or a completion of something that was in love that has came to an ending, or the cycle has ended, okay? Yes, and it's coming up again. Notice your health. Try to be as healthy as you can. Eat right, sleep right. Okay, because it may be hindering your creativity, or if not, it can enhance your creativity if you do so, and heal. It can heal you, okay? And causes a lot of abundance, but you will have a lot of abundance if you cleanse yourself, eat well, and heal from all old wounds, okay? Yeah. Bottom of the deck, self-love. Somebody needs to practice self-love. All these things that I've mentioned were self-love acts, okay? These are things that you can do to practice self-love. Let's go in deep, okay? Let's go in deep. I'm going to use my African tarot deck as soon as I can get it out. Okay, here we go. Here we go, African Tarot deck. And by the way, you may want to start protecting yourself for your evil thoughts, your own evil thoughts against yourself, and all of those things of that nature. You can do so with, I have black tourmaline around my neck. All negative energy and negative vibes are being pushed away from around me because I don't play that, okay? So show me what I need to know. Show me. Yeah, okay. So somebody is the King of Pentacles. Somebody is stable. Somebody has some things that are working out in their favor, and they have stability, okay? Yes, and they are aiming for the Ten of Pentacles. A stable family, a household, your life that's going to lead them. That's that environment. Somebody wants a stable household. My nose itching. God, your time. Okay, thank you, Spirit. Thank you, God. Thank you, ancestors. Oh, shoot. Okay, hold on. No. Got that in my wine. Okay, anyways, here we go. Somebody is being the observer. They're observing things. They're trying to figure out what's going on. They're listening to their intuition most of all when they observe things, because those eyes are closed. So you're not really seeing with your eyes. You're seeing with your third eye, your spiritual eye, okay? Because they have their eye on the Empress, okay? See that owl? She's also all-knowing. Very fertile, very, very beautiful. Overflowing with love, overflowing with everything. Motherhood, fertility. She's overflowing. She knows all, sees all. She's beautiful. She got her things together. And somebody wants judgment. Judgment with this person. They want to make sure that they want a new beginning. And they're scared about getting cut out by this person. They don't want to get cut out by this person. Because possibly somebody may be pregnant. Or possibly that they're pregnant with new ideas for this person. But they don't want them to cut them out. Because they know that they have to work hard for this individual. Because they had to put an end into old ways and come into the new, because they knew that they had to come different this time. They had to put an end into they have to work hard from all those obsessions that they have and all those poor things that they did to this person, okay? Yeah, because they really want a family with you. Four of Wands. They want the family. They want a happy life. They want to live together. Okay. Home, marriage, stability. That's what that is. Four of Wands. Yeah, because they realize they've been acting like a little boy or a little girl, running around giving that little wand and page to everybody, and it's been wearing, tearing them thin that they've been doing it, because they really don't like the fact that they've been doing it, and they've been a true master of playing, okay, playing around, okay. And this person played around so much that the tower came down on them, came down hard on them, things broke apart on them. And why did things break apart on this person? What was the tower for this person? What was the tower for this person? What was this tower for this person? Yeah, they lost their Queen of Pentacles. They lost their Queen of Pentacles, okay? Because while he was out here supposed to be the Emperor, she was supposed to be the Emperor in their power and all knowing and portraying that they were being who they were supposed to be. And having all this love and was supposed to be honoring this person and was supposed to be having a... They were being selfish, basically. Nine of Pentacles can be selfish. They were being selfish on this tip. They were being selfish. Okay? They were having... They were really loving themselves and loving the person that they are. They really weren't trying to give you the affection and the attention that you were trying to get. They really didn't want to see you move on, because they feel like if you move on, it would kind of sort of put them in a certain type of situation, make them know, feel about themselves that, hey, you really were the one that was on the bullshit. I'm sorry. That's what, yeah. Yeah, because you was on the bullshit because you broke a heart. You broke this person's heart, okay? And this person had a lot of love for you, but you put, you Five of Pentacles them. You left them in the dark. You left them out in the cold, okay? Made them feel stupid. Leave them out in the cold like they were nobody to you. Yeah, and now you're ready to work hard to give this person a new beginning and something stable. You really want to give this person a new beginning and something stable, and you really want to show this person that you can do it, because at the bottom of the deck, you want the wheel to change. You want the Wheel of Fortune to change. You really want something to come about this situation. Excuse me. Top of the deck. King of Swords. You're ready to cut the bullshit out because you really know how this person feels about you. Okay? And you really know how you feel about this person. What's stopping this person from coming forward right now? This person is still fighting off battles with people. There's some evil people that they still have to fight battles off with. You see that person over there? There's some evil spirits that are still upon this person that they have to fight. Okay. Yeah, and right now they feel like they don't have enough to come to you. Page of Pentacles. They don't have enough to come to you. But soon, the sun will come out and there will be a rebirth in this relationship. Okay, because this is a past life relationship. Okay, and this person knows a lot now. What they thought they didn't know and what they thought they knew, they don't know anymore. Now they have a whole new perspective about things. Yeah, they have a whole new perspective on who they need to choose and who they love. Who they want to grow old with. That's a whole new perspective. A perspective right there, okay? Yeah, now that person wants to step out there and be that fool. I don't care what's over here, but the grass was, I thought it was greener on this side, but I'm going back over here to where I came from because I'm ready to be the fool. This is a past connection that I feel, okay? Yeah, I'm going to put an ending to all these nasty little relationships that I've had. If you was a man, nasty little relationships you had. If you was a woman, you ready to put all that to rest because that really don't even matter to you no more, okay? Because you want this family. You want this family with this person. You want the wish fulfillment with this person, okay? You want satisfaction and happiness, and you want to bring justice into this person's life because you know what you've done to this person, okay? And then you want to be the magician, and you want to start and manifest new things in this life, and you no longer want to use your magic powers for bad. You want to use them for good, okay? Yes, because you know that the person that you robbed, basically emotionally and mentally, you robbed her, but you know, or you robbed him, but you know that's your lover. You know that's somebody who you really love. You really love that person, the one that you were being sneaky with. Okay? Hit home for me, then. I found an outcome. He's going to show and prove, or she's going to show and prove that love. All that water around, there's an overflowing of love, okay? An overflowing of love that's coming out of this situation, okay? Yes. All right. Let me go into my... I think I'm going to do the Love Angels, Romance Angel cards. And then after that, I'm going to do the Moonology, if I have enough time on my camera. So the Romance Angels, this is the small deck. I love it. Oh, I love it. Okay. Show me love messages. Show me love messages. For the collective, love messages. For the collective. Let go of control issues. Allow the situation to unfold naturally. So stop worrying about it. Let it go. Surrender it to power because that's the only time it's going to happen. And I said surrender it to divine power. Look what happens. Religious factors. Okay? Your love life is influenced by religious factors, upbringings, and spiritual paths. Okay? So this is your spiritual path with this person. You have chemistry. That there's a strong magnetic attraction here. So you have a chemistry with this person, a great chemistry with this person, okay? This is your true love. This is a romance of a lifetime. You guys have true love, okay? Make the effort. So great love is worth taking the steps you're guided to take. So, guys, somebody needs to make the effort. Maybe this person is going to make the effort soon. Okay? Because they're taking time to release their ex. Okay, this time has, the time has come to clear your energy. So they need to clear their energy of their ex because they have a lot of passion for you guys, okay? Allow your heart and soul to sing with joy. And they may be coming in with an engagement or want to be engaged to you, okay? All right. I'm really enjoying the vibe of the reggae. And I got my wine. I'm doing my cards. Tarot card reading. So I'm happy. Alright, we're going into the moonology deck. Let's get us some advice, spirit. Advice on the collective on what they need to do. God. Right now, advice. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, advice. Okay. Advice. Advice. Okay, it's time to take action. New moon in Aries. It's time to take action. So anybody who wants to take action towards somebody and you're kind of scared and afraid of what may happen, or you messed up in the past or whatever, you're scared, just take the action. You never know what's going to happen. Your hard work is paying off. New moon in Capricorn. Your hard work is paying off. It says, don't let the past hold you back. I just said that. Doesn't matter what happened in the past, because guess what? A new start is coming in, with the new moon, y'all. A new start is coming. It's time to release negativity at the end of the deck. And at the top of the deck is, don't let pride get in your way. Then we have a card with pride in it beforehand. Tell me, spirit is not on point today. Thank you, spirit. Yes, so I'm going to leave you with this. Everybody makes mistakes. I've made a few in my day. I've seen people make a few to me, a few mistakes with me. All I can say is we all are not supernatural people. We all are people that are just living in this world that we're living in, you know, and we're going to make mistakes, you know. As long as you learn from them and don't make too many of them, you'll be okay. You feel me? So I'm not here to judge people. I'm here to lead the way or show you some things that you may not see, or have some you can have clarification from this or anything of the nature. But I just want you to know that people make mistakes. People can be forgiven. And the more that you hold on to things and not forgive, that shows you what type of person that you're willing to be to yourself. I like to treat myself well, so I don't hold any grudges. I like to treat myself well, so therefore I am empathetic and I am compassionate, because I want to see how did I make that person feel, or how you know, I want to see the other side all the time. See, when I start telling the truth, God make my nose itch. Okay. But I just want you to know that everybody makes mistakes and everybody should be forgiven. Now, that doesn't say for you to go off and make 3,000 mistakes on somebody that keeps on forgiving you, because one day that person's not going to want to forgive you anymore, and they're going to move on. They're going to forgive you, but they're not going to forget. And they're going to move on from you, even though they've forgiven you. And that's the worst thing that you want them to do, because that means I don't have to be with you. I don't have to be around you. I love you from afar. Let me long handle spoon you. But guess what? I forgive you. And I'm moving on with my life. See, that's how you do things. Forgiveness is very, 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 very important. Because if you can forgive, God can forgive you. Point blank. And I always want to be forgiven for whatever I may have done. You know? Yeah, I'm looking at this scar. Oh, I'm about to go put some shea butter on it. It'll be gone in 3 days. But, yeah. I just want to let you all know to live, love, and light all over the place. Shine your bright star. Shine your bright light. We are here. And while we're here, we need to live the best lives that we can. So anyways, comment, write, subscribe, like, so my videos can go and, you know, meet people around so I can give them some inspiration, you guys. This is what it's all about. I'm trying to inspire through my craft, one of my crafts that I have, one of the many crafts, thank you, that I have. I'm happy I have a lot of crafts because it keeps me busy. It keeps me off my own brain. But anyway, you all have a nice night. I'm going to enjoy the rest of my night. Watch me a little YouTube, movies on Netflix, and go to bed. You guys have a nice night. Wine kicking in. Peace.